That's all Jesus. Gandhi opened up.
Did you hear that?
That was
Ulama saying things like that.
Are you gonna
justify that?
Yeah, I'm.
Brother, listen.
Are you gonna ask me a question and let me answer it?
No.
Brother, look. Brother, please don't bring that discussion.
Please, brother.
Leave an emotional response.
Brother, bro.
You're not emotional. Why are you being so
emotional?
Let me. I'm asking the Sheikh. I'm challenging you on behalf of Mufti. Not even challenging. Mufti Abu Lay said, I don't want to have a debate with Nan.
But he could never have a debate. He would never have a debate with him.
I
want to
have a discussion.
He's not that capacity.
I think he's higher. I think he's higher. My respect, Sheikh.
The thing is, everybody's higher. That's why I know.
You know what he says? Yeah. You could have five spliffs. If them five spliffs have an effect on you, brother, I've heard it.
Come on,
you see a fight, Sheikh, you know what he's ruling?
We sat with him, man. We sat with him, bro.
Certain brothers
bro, we sat with him. We sat with him. Me and Hijab sat with him.
It's a smoker.
Bro, me and Hijab, we sat with him, yeah? We were chilling with him. He said to me, he goes, how do I know if I die, I don't see Ganesh?
Allahu Akbar.
He said,
you're going to take deen
from him. Listen, I said to myself, okay, maybe like it's not clear, yeah? He said, yeah, how do you know if I die, maybe I might see Ganesh? And I was gobsmacked.
Forget about it. He's not important. My question to you is, as a young man, you're a young man with intelligence, mashallah.
Yeah. Obviously, you have to check
with Why would you waste your time or spend your time going to someone like that who has a controversial, at least, if not definitely, at least there are stigmas attached to him.
Mufti.
Well, why would you not go to Shah Waliullah?
Subhanallah.
Yeah. Yeah, Imam Ghazali, okay. Ibn Taymiyyah.
Let him speak, bro. I don't know why are you being a puppet for Sheikh. Come on,
no, brother, don't call me a puppet on camera. Because you know what? I'm from Birmingham.
I know.
Please. No, let's not do that.
Oh, hey,
Chuck.
Oh,
yaar.
I'm talking
about Sheikh. But don't insult me.
Please, not with me.
Let Sheikh speak then.
Have some camera.
Let this speak. I'm having a discussion for Mufti. I'm saying, you know I insulting Mufti Abu Layf, is that fine? You can do that, that's your prerogative.
Don't insult me.
But why are you insulting Mufti Abu Layf then?
Is he here to protect himself?
Yeah. No, I'm speaking to you.
Are you recording it?
Can I record it? No,
you can't.
Well, the others are recording.
You've got proper cameras, we don't need to talk for
phones. Listen, I'm saying let's have a discussion.
Yeah. But why would I have a discussion with him? I know he's on.
No, he's not disrespectful. None of us are disrespectful.
Why would he be disrespectful? No, don't worry, let me speak.
Why are you so angry, man?
Intoxicated or not? That's fine.
Maybe I'm wrong, yeah? Correct me. But I'm saying I've met Mufti Abu Layf. He's a lovely guy. Come and sit
Mashallah.
Down.
I'm sure he is.
No, it's fine. Yeah. Come and chat with him.
Mashallah.
Have a discussion. Let's have a discussion.
What for though? What's the purpose of this?
Let's have a discussion about Hadith. So, you know, let's have a
but
discussion.
But why would I? No. Look.
Yeah,
you're saying Mufti Abu Layf is high up, which is good, mashallah.
Yeah.
You have good feelings about him.
Yeah.
But I know for a fact that there are giants.
Yeah.
Mufti Abu Layf wouldn't be sitting. He's not even able to sit in the feet. And they have written books, and they have already scrutinized every single hadith in the hadith literature.
Yeah.
I'm talking about Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, I'm talking about Imam Suyuti, I'm talking about big authorities in the science of hadith.
Yeah.
Why would I listen to a joker like Mufti Abu Layth? I'll tell you why joker. Because he's a joker.
He's a joker.
That's what I'm calling him a joker.
Of course. Could you be wrong in your understanding?
Yeah.
Could you be wrong? I'm asking that question.
No.
Okay.
I'll tell you why. On hadith...
I could be wrong. I'll explain to you.
On hadith,
go on.
There is ijma. There is ijma of all the muhaddithin. How many? All. I'm using the word all with capital A and double L, capital. All the muhaddithin, they have ijma on the validity of the hadith we have in Bukhari and Muslim.
That's not true.
Listen to my words and challenge them. Tell him to challenge. I'm saying all the muhaddithin.
That's not true.
No.
I know that's good.
Understand my words first.
Okay, go on.
Right. I'm saying all muhaddithin are unanimous that the reports in Bukhari and Muslim are overwhelmingly authentic.
Yeah.
They might have a problem with one or two reports here and there. For example, Albani said there are one or two reports in Bukhari. They may be a room for discussion.
Yeah, sure. But they don't say Mufti Abu Layth says.
But no, wait.
I could be wrong.
Yeah.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I could be wrong.
Wait,
no.
Wakar, wait. Now, Mufti Abu Layth is a young man. Yeah, he's still learning, and his Arabic pronunciation when he reads. I've studied Arabic, so I know when he's speaking Arabic and Arabic. Why should I waste my time with someone like
that?
He's a brother.
For lay people, no, I know Sheikh. Good. And so I come here. I respect Sheikh.
My question is, when I have.
But why do so many people run away then? Sheikh Atabek. Why?
Because he's just chatting nonsense, brother. With all due respect,
brother. How do you know? You're not an alim, bro.
Yeah.
So how do you know he's chatting nonsense?
I might be wrong. You're right. I don't know. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. So for us, as
but Sheikh is saying there's people out there, you know, mashallah, very big scholars that have made written books on what he's giving commentary on that are already set in stone. Why do you have to collect questions?
My brother,
brother, 1400 years after the Prophet, you got a better understanding.
Ibn Hajar, the Saudis have messed around with that interpretation. We've got proof.
Which interpretation?
Ibn Hajar Asqalani.
What are you talking about? We know, for example, they've messed around. In printing?
In print.
I have the 19th century print in my library.
Yeah, that's fine. So we can compare it.
I have it.
That's fine.
I have it.
We can compare it.
I can get you Makhtutat of Fathul Bari if you want.
But even Sheikh Abdul Hakim Muraj has talked about how people tamper with books, how people tamper with tafsirs, how people have
tampered. How does that dismantle the entire science of hadith?
Because if you're saying to me, for example, Fathul Bari, we're talking about Ibn Hajar Asqalani, rahimahullah, if he said something. Now, if that's been tampered with, what did he say, the full sentence, etc.? You know what I'm saying?
Full sentence.
So what's the full paragraph?
That's fine.
Brother, there's a shape. Well, my minor issues. What do you understand
Brother,
what would you extrapolate from the science of hadith? If they do go into detail.
Let me clarify something.
SubhanAllah, man. These
on Fathul Bari. Yeah. Or at-tamheed of Imam the Sharh of Imam Malik or other shuruhat, you can differ on a sentence or two. That someone maybe mistranslated it or possibly misrepresented it somehow. But based on that, to make a claim that ahadith or ahad, they were forged en masse, Okay, wait. This is now what you're telling me, Ibn Hajar.
The world wrong.
Go away. Forget about Ibn Hajar. All the hadith authorities from the 2nd century up to the 19th century were a bunch of idiots. Wait. You're telling me over 1,000 scholars with credentials, having studied Islam for over 50 years,
60, 70 years.
On average, are a bunch of idiots, and I want to listen to. You want me to?
No.
You have to say that.
No, because you want to question their work.
You want to question their work.
We have a right to question things.
Why do you have a right to question their work?
Because Allah's given us a brain. Yeah. But some people, if you just want to accept it, that's fine. That's your problem.
No problem. Let's question it.
You know, I come from an academic background.
That's not academic.
If you listen,
wait. Don't argue with him. Let me deal with this contention.
Deal with the shaitaniyat.
Brothers, let me deal with this contention. He has questions. Let me deal with them directly. The point is, you're saying, you know, this phenomenon, for example, hadith rejection.
I'm not rejecting hadith.
I know.
I don't reject.
Wait. Let me.
But you just.
Wait. Let me clarify something. This phenomenon. The phenomenon in which people question the validity of a hadith contained within Bukhari and Muslim.
Are you screaming?
No problem. Are you screaming live?
Yes. So, yeah, because people we're having a discussion about.
Okay, no problem.
Yes, Sheikh said
it's fine. 50.
There's only three people on it, bro. Look, the kicking.
Yeah.
So, oh wait, I'm not gonna press charges.
Okay. Press charges for what? Did I do to you? That you're gonna press charges?
The charger for your phone. The charger.
Yeah, but brother, when you start coming out with the crap that you come out with, brother, you're gonna get.
Why can't we have a civilized conversation?
I'm not a sheikh, by the way.
Ustad.
Yeah.
Ustad, sorry.
Okay, now let me clarify something.
I respect you for a long time.
Very quickly, I want to clarify something. This phenomenon of questioning the validity of Bukhari and Muslim, it is a 19th century phenomenon. Wait. It started in the subcontinent with Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, and then after him a man called Abdullah Chakralvi. Okay, these guys. And then came Pervez. Okay, they rejected hadith. Okay, and then this disease spread throughout. Wait. Most people who are questioning the hadith. Mm.
Yeah. Hanafis, this is where I'm coming from.
No, which Hanafi? Atabek? Atabek?
No, I'm talking about Hanafi Imam Jassas, from one of our early scholars.
Yeah, what do you say?
He's, for example, the hadith where it talks about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam having magic on him, astaghfirullah. Yeah. Or the hadith about Moses alayhi salam naked and the rocks running over.
Brother, you're just referring back to
the monkeys stoning each other.
Yeah.
We reject that. Okay. We reject that, and that's the Hanafi fiqh. That's our principle.
Why do you reject that?
Okay, so we have certain principles. So if it goes against the Quran or against a certain rational, Imam Al Jawziyah, which is from your school,
who gave this principle?
Say that if it goes against rationality, we reject it.
Rationality changes from time to time. Do you agree? Do you agree? Wait. Rationality changes from time to time, from place to place, right?
But monkeys stoning each other.
Okay, let's talk about it. Who reported it?
Who reported the monkey stoning?
Yeah, monkey report.
I know who reported it.
Are you taking from hearsay?
Does that make sense? It's irrational that the fact that you don't even understand where you're coming from and you want
to. Let me explain.
We're having a discussion, my brother. We don't have to.
You're having a discussion, but you don't even understand where you're coming from.
The monkey reported from someone.
Can you tell people that we're having a rational discussion?
Yeah.
We're not here hyped up. I'm not asking. We don't need to be disrespectful to each other. Do you understand?
Brother, with all due respect, the way you... Okay, no problem.
I'm not being disrespectful to you.
You couldn't be disrespectful to me, brother, so be very careful on that.
No, listen.
Okay.
If I have... Listen to me.
Brother, no problem. I'm sorry, but you could never anyway. But just carry on having... That's fine. Just having a discussion.
Let's leave the egos aside and stuff. We're having a discussion.
No problem.
Okay, let's carry on. So the report about the... Who What's wrong with that? First of all, a man saw something, okay, and he described it, okay? Now, what he saw, how he saw it, okay, he's describing it. And he's not attributing this to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not attributing. So, what's the problem with it? Yeah, I know it's in Bukhari, it's in Sahih. We believe it's Sahih, we believe the authenticity.
You believe the hadith though, be honest.
That what?
That monkeys stoning each other.
Brother, go on YouTube and you'll see monkeys do some irrational things as well.
Monkeys don't get married.
No. The hadith doesn't say that they got married. Hadith doesn't say they got married.
Doesn't it say the after?
No, hadith says...
Adultery.
He saw certain monkeys doing certain things and stoning each other. Yeah. Okay. And then he interpreted the incident as follows. That the monkey saw... the monkeys were having sex with each other. One monkey had sex with a female. Another monkey came. And then other monkeys picked up stones and they stoned her. And this is... Allah showed me Rajam before Rajam was revealed. This is the point he's making, right? What's wrong with that? He's interpreting certain actions of animals. Analogy. Have you ever seen monkeys throwing things at you? Have you ever seen
that? Yes,
they have.
I've seen it.
Yeah. I live in, sometimes I go to Pakistan, Islamabad. Yeah. We go to Margala Hills. There are monkeys. So if someone sees monkeys throwing stones at each other or at a particular monkey, that person interprets that particular incident in a certain way, that's his interpretation.
But that's what we're doing. We're saying, let's have that.
So what's the problem with this now? There are two options here.
Number one option. Yeah. In this incident, monkeys were actually stoning the female monkey or the male monkey.
Yeah. Quite strong.
For adultery. Yeah, quite and this was a supernatural, supernatural event. Yeah, to show Rajam will come. So this, that's one option. And I don't follow that option. The other option is, this Sahabi, in fact, there is a discussion on this, whether he was a Sahabi or Tabi. Okay. He saw certain animals doing certain things and he interpreted those incidents or those actions in his own way. And his interpretation can be either accepted or rejected. That's it. What's the problem? Yeah. Why do people now start to...
I know, man. Yeah. No, but that's one hadith, yeah?
Give me more. I'm hungry.
So Imam...
More. Give me more.
Next.
Give me more. Next one.
Okay. So, that's what I'm saying.
Monkey running away. Stone running away.
Ustaji, why don't you say... This is what I'm saying. We don't...
Are you the middleman?
I'm the middleman, yeah.
You're the middleman?
I'm the middleman, yeah.
So the Sheikh, wants to have a sit down.
I feel that so many people...
Brother, he's the middleman for someone who's not here.
I respect Sheikh Ustad Adnan, and
everyone.
No problem. Let him report.
I said,
no problem.
Mufti Abu Layth was one of those. I respect Mufti Abu Layth. I respect Sheikh Atabek.
We respect all people like that. That's fine. No problem.
That's fine. Yeah. I'm saying.
Atabek, by the way, Atabek has been completely rejected by Hanafis, by tradition, the Bundis.
Hold on.
No, Brelvis. Brelvis and Bundis. What does Asrar Rashid say about?
That's fine.
There you go.
I respect
Asrar Rashid. Asrar Rashid is not Deobandi.
No, he's Brelvi.
Yes,
he's Brelvi.
Although he doesn't like to call himself.
He calls himself Ashari Hanafi. Yeah.
So Hanafis don't accept Atabek is one man who's coming up with some wild theories. The Hanafis don't accept them.
But have you read his book? Have you read his book?
I've read it, and there are so many problems with it that a student like me, a basic student like me, is laughing. So how can this man write this book?
So why don't we get yourself, I'll book out LSE or Berwick College. We'll get Mufti Abu Layth, Sheikh Atabek, we'll sit down, we'll have a
discussion. Where are you going to get the funds from to do that?
Don't worry about the funds.
Don't worry about it.
We've got enough people, bro.
What will the discussion be about? The discussion.
We'll say Bukhari revisited. You could.
No. We'll say that are these two individuals serving an agenda in Britain?
Thank you very much. Where they're getting funded by?
Why not? Why not?
That's wrong.
Why not? If someone said that about me, I would be the first person to be there.
But are you serving an agenda for Saudi Arabia?
Yeah, no problem. I'll come. I'll discuss it.
And Sheikh Mohammed. You and Sheikh Mohammed. Mufti Abu Layth, Sheikh Atabek. No. I'm not.
Yeah, you know what,
I'm not doing it.
If he's recording, he's recording. No problem.
What's the MI6?
And the relationship.
How many views have you got?
Ustad, let's go.
Don't worry about it, man.
These people, you don't get away from them, man. They got disgusting agendas.
I have to leave now.
You got a disgusting agenda.
I have to leave.
Wallahi,
you got a disgusting agenda.
Wallahi,
I have got a disgusting agenda.
Ustad knows me. I haven't got
a disgusting agenda. My advice again is, instead of sitting with people like Abu Layth and Atabek, we have giants from the past who have studied.
Correct me. I could be wrong, bro.
What's happening in Palestine?
I raise money for Palestine. I raise money for Palestine.
Let's leave this thing. Brother, listen. Let's leave this thing. And talk about Palestine. Let's not talk about Mufti Abu Layth. I don't care where you're from. Wallah, I don't care where you're from.
I'm going to leave now. The point I'm making is,
Sufism is only a dark cutter, right? True form of Islam. How do you know this?